In this example, we are given that a rod AB of length L is placed in a cylindrical region time varying magnetic field as shown in figure with its rate of increasing C Tesla per second. Here we are given with the value of dB by dt. And we are required to find the potential difference across the ends of the rod due to induced electric field in the region. Now in this situation, if we just analyze the potential difference across ends A and B, then we can see at every point of the rod, the distance from center of this region is different. So induced electric field will also be different. So to calculate it, let us consider an element of width dx from the center of the rod. And at this point, we can see as in downward direction, magnetic induction is increasing. And electric field is induced in anticlockwise manner. So at the location of this dx, electric field will be tangential to the circular electric line of force. So this will be in this direction. So if this angle is theta, correspondingly here we can say this angle is also theta. So we can write in this situation potential difference across the element dx is, this will be dE, and this we can write as E dx cos theta. Because across two points where electric field is E, we can write the potential difference dV is E dot dx. So it will be E dx cos theta. And the value of electric field inside at a distance, this distance is root of r square plus x square. The electric field we can write as half root of r square plus x square multiplied by dV by dt, which is C here, multiplied by dx. Multiplied by, we substitute the value of cos theta from this triangle, this will be r divided by root of r square plus x square, which also gets cancelled out. And here in this situation, the value of EMF induced across the element dx, we can write as half cr dx. So we can directly state total potential difference across the rod AB is, this can be given as integration of dE, which is integrated within limits from minus L by 2 to plus L by 2. So the value of EMF we are getting directly is half CRL. That will be the answer to this problem. But in this situation, we just have a look on the high and low potential, and we can see that E cos theta is toward point B. But in this situation, one important thing which is useful is when we talk about the free electrons of the rod, we can see as the induced electric field is towards right, the free electrons in the rod will experience a force toward left and will drift to point A. So point A will be slightly negative, and due to shift of electrons, B will be slightly positive. So we can directly state in this situation, point A will be the low potential end and point B will be the high potential end. In this situation, you must be very careful about the polarity of the potential difference induced across point A and B, as due to induced electric field, we can see it exists from A to B. So conventionally, B should be at low potential, but here, as the potential is developed due to shift of the charges, the polarity will be opposite in this situation.